everyone. Welcome into My Chamber TV, the heartbeat of our community. I'm your host today, Barbara Marville Kelly. Thank you so much for joining us. Today, we honor the Palm Harbor Chamber of Commerce. And of course, with all due respect, we have Kelly Snow, who is joining us today, filling in for the ever so popular Jewel McKeon. Jewel, if you're out there, a shout out to you. I know Kelly's going to be doing a great job, even in spite of, what is it, the red tide that's affecting our voices?
It is, absolutely. I get this low, rustic voice today, so bear with me.
Well, maybe we can get you to just sing some country.
I know, that would go right. That'd go really well with some events we've got coming up.
I know. Well, this is really an honor to have you stepping in the shoes of Jewel McKeon, who's been doing a great job for almost 2 years being the spokesperson with Palm Harbor Chamber. But you are not unfamiliar with Palm Harbor Chamber. You've been doing so much with them for a good little while.
I actually am very involved for, it'll be 6 years this January.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. So I think we're going to hear a lot from Kelly that she can share what's happening with the Palm Harbor Chamber. If you're tuning in for the first time, welcome. We're here every Wednesday at 3:30, really raising the awareness of the various chambers and different events that are coming up in the community as well. So, but the one thing that I wanted to talk just a little bit about before we do mention our guests that are coming up and the special events, Palm Harbor Chamber is different than most of the chambers. Why is that?
Yes, we are. And I believe the number one reason is because we are not a city.
Not a city.
So our funding is from our events, our membership, and basically that makes us different. We don't have funding coming from any other source or any other place other than the people in our community.
So
they sponsor us.
That's a lot of support, isn't it?
It is. It actually is. But we, you know, we do great. We have great events and very successful chamber.
Yes, it is a very successful chamber. And I'll tell you, when you want to see the heartbeat of a community, you know, drop into the chamber and you're going to see that camaraderie that is just amazing. And I didn't realize how close-knit the chambers were until I started doing these shows. Uh-oh. Excuse me, that's one of those live TV things, and I'm just being told in my ear that's costing me a dollar. I actually had my phone turned off.
So say, do you have a jar that you have to put money in?
Yeah, it's right over there. It's a big bottle. It's the oops jar. So I now owe it $2 because my phone went off during the live presentation. It's okay. That's what we do here. It's all live, totally unrehearsed, unscripted, and all that. So getting back to the chamber and, you know, some of the different things that they're doing. I know I participated in that wonderful event in April of this year where I filled in for Jewel and did the Dancing with the Local Stars.
Oh, yes.
That was so much fun. It really was. But doing these shows, I really get a chance to see the pulse of everybody and to see how you all engage with one another and how you make these different events happen. So coming up in just a little bit, we have the Citrus Queen.
Yes, we do.
Kiana.
Our gorgeous Citrus Queen.
Oh, is she ever. And she's got a nice little story to tell in relation to some of the different events, scholarships, and programs that you guys support down there in Palm Harbor.
We do.
And then there's another guest that's coming on, Pastor Mark, who's going to be talking about really donating food and helping the hungry. And that is just, that's just so close to my heart. And I think I mentioned to you guys earlier that many years ago, I was in a position very close to that. And that's not something that I really go out and share, but when I can give exposure and raise the voice and raise the awareness of a high percentage of the hungry right here in very affluent neighborhoods.
Right.
It will blow your
mind. It's astounding. It really is.
I had no idea. I really had no idea.
I'm going to safely say most people watching this right now have no idea.
That's
right. The statistics, because it is. It's very devastating.
Exactly.
But we can do something about that.
Yes, we can. It's not as devastating as it could be. And so people who step up, step out, and really put together programs, that's how we make the community
absolutely.
Not only profitable, but we engage one another. And goodness knows, don't we need more love and caring in this world today?
Yes, we do. And it's great when we have opportunities that we can connect to like that.
Exactly.
And make a difference.
Especially this time of the year. I mean, this time of the year, it's holiday season, and this is where we really can give back. But you guys with the chambers, I mean, it's all year long. It you have is. Things going all year
long. We do,
long.
All year long, where and we can help our community.
Absolutely. And I know you have some special events coming up in January,
yes,
February.
We do. March.
March.
April.
Is it too early to talk about that? I don't think
is
so.
Is it too early to talk about 2016?
I don't think so. It's right around the corner.
It is.
So share with us.
You mean give you some dates?
Yeah, give us
well,
some.
Well, the next event, we just finished our art show, which was fabulous. We had an incredible time. And coming up next is our Citrus Festival. And that's going to be January 21st through 24th. It is a four-day full event.
Wow.
We have bands, carnival rides for the kids. That wonderful food trucks are going to be there. And, you know, there's going to be some vendors and some community partners that are going to have, you know, their tents out there with all their materials. So you can find out more about our community.
That is very, very cool. Yeah. And I know, well, I think that you had mentioned, what was it, or did it pass already? There's something where you were dressing up for an event.
It's coming up.
Can we talk about it?
Yes, we can. We have our Evening Extraordinaire.
That's it.
Goes Country Western. And I don't know if that's the way to say it anymore, but that's just what I know of. You get to wear, you know, your cowboy boots and come on out and dance with us, and there's going to be food galore. Wonderful music, and we just, it honestly, Evening Extraordinaire is to honor the people in our community. Just anybody can come. There's, you know, no one is, you know, not invited. Everyone's invited to come. It's going to be at Innisbrook, and we just have a blast. It is so much fun, and you get to dress up and kick your heels.
I love it. I love it. That is going to be fun. And Innisbrook in Palm Harbor, that
gorgeous.
Oh my goodness. They have the most beautiful ballrooms there.
And we're in the largest ballroom that's there, and it's just beautiful the way they can transform it.
I bet.
For your events.
I bet.
Yeah.
So that's going to be coming up.
Yeah, that's actually March 10th.
That'll
I forgot we last year it was in January. We moved it to March this year, but it's just it is an annual event.
It is an annual event. Now how long have you been doing that?
I'm going to say, I know it's over 20.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
But I'm not sure how many, but it's transformed
uh-huh.
and become different things.
Sure.
And it's a different theme every year. Last year we had a Hollywood theme. This year it's country.
I think that's good.
I'm excited about country.
I know, because that's written all over
it
you.
It is. I'm all about it. I can't wait.
Oh, I can't wait to see your outfit.
You know it.
It's going to be so much fun.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
Well, you know, when you get involved with some of these different events, and you can't help but want to know what is next coming. Right. So that's why it's always good to see what's happening in your community. One way to do that is join your local Chamber of Commerce, or even drop in. Even if you aren't a business owner, but you want to see what's going on, go over to the Palm Harbor Chamber of Commerce, because I'll tell you, there's a lot of high energy, a lot of really positive things going on over there, and it's up to you to go ahead and check it out. I had no idea till I started doing these shows in all the different areas in our neighborhoods, even surrounding neighborhoods, all the different events that are going on that are not just charity, but a lot charity, but then also to help you grow your business. If you do have a small business, this is a perfect way to really engage yourself,
is.
Right?
It really is. Mm-hmm. One thing that I really love about our chamber is it does touch all those areas.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we do give opportunity for people to get involved in what we're doing, and we give back.
Yes.
Every event we do, we give back to an organization in our area. You know,
yes.
like the food pantries,
yes.
and
yes.
and it helps. I mean, you can't, it warms your heart to know that you're going, I'm going to a great art show, but I know part of the proceeds are going back to the community.
See, so. And there's nothing like that. There's nothing like the feeling you
yeah.
have when you're doing that. When Jewel asked me to, or no, it wasn't Jewel, it was Connie that asked me to dance. And I tell my husband this all the time. If it was for me, I wouldn't have done that. But there's a different feeling when you're dancing for dollars
Absolutely.
For somebody else.
Absolutely.
And
so
it's just it's just so different, and I can't wait for the next things to come rolling our way. And with Tampa Bay Multimedia, it's great that we can do this show, and this goes all around the globe that we can raise the awareness on what chambers are doing. So if you're not watching in sunny Florida and you're somewhere else, think about getting involved with your chamber. But here today we're talking about the Palm Harbor Chamber of Commerce, all the great things they do. And it is a beautiful community. I think I may have mentioned before, when my mom moved down here to Michigan, where did I put her? Palm Harbor.
Palm Harbor.
Palm Harbor was where she went, and she loved it until she took her trip north, and she's now with the Angels, and I was so glad that I did that because she could walk within distance.
Right.
She didn't drive, and there was just a lot going on. So what are some of the key things that you feel, as a member of the chamber, that people can do to get involved, or what are some of your key points?
You were talking about beautiful. Mm-hmm. I wanted to throw this in. We have our parade. Our holiday parade is this weekend, and I'm actually the Grand Marshal, believe it or not.
What does the Grand Marshal do?
Grand Marshal of the parade. You ride in the first car with the sign that says Grand Marshal.
All righty, then.
That's what happens when you don't attend a meeting. You get nominated to be the Grand Marshal.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, it's pretty funny. But that's a perfect opportunity to come out to one of our outside events like that to mm-hmm. see how gorgeous our area is. Mm-hmm. And back to your question, you can get involved in the parade. You can get involved in any of our area YMCA. We connect with all those companies. The center, which is was formerly the senior center of the area, our chamber, networks with them all the time, and we do events together. So when you come into the Palm Harbor Chamber of Commerce, you get a package deal. You get so much more than what you would maybe think or expect.
Really?
Yeah, you do, because we've got every event, we want you there. Even from our coffee hours, which is the first Thursday of every month at our library, mm-hmm. so you get exposed to what the library is doing.
And that is lovely. I've been to those.
It's really fun.
Yes,
I mean,
yes.
it's a rally. We get
oh my goodness.
Rally everybody together.
The energy. And what time is it in the morning?
7:30.
Where do you guys get all this energy?
I know. It's amazing. And then we have our coffee for closures, which mm-hmm. is a perfect opportunity for businesses.
Yes.
And what I think, not just new businesses, but what I've been getting out of it is businesses that may need a little stirring up.
Sure, sure.
Get a little
sure.
more energy in there.
Yes.
What better than to get in a room full of people who have great ideas that they can share with you?
It's contagious.
It is.
It really is contagious. And, you need that. You have to have some energy when
Absolutely.
You have your business.
Absolutely.
And really stir up that passion
yes.
in your business. And if you can't stir up the passion, maybe it's time to think about moving on to something else.
Do something else.
Exactly. Exactly.
I totally agree. But, the chamber is a perfect place. Even we call our chamber the Welcome Center of Palm Harbor. Which, do I have a few seconds I can talk a little bit
you
about
do.
That?
You do. We have just about a minute and a half or so.
Okay, let me tell you about the newest member of the chamber is Palmer. And she is the dolphin that we now have adopted.
Oh.
And she is, it's a statue. But it's awesome. We're on the treasure hunt that the
yes,
Clearwater
yes.
set up.
Yes.
And it's the Pearl of Palm Harbor. And we named her Palmer. And Jan Rush, a local artist who's also in the chamber, painted it for us. And it is now home in front of our chamber.
How cool is
so
that?
So you get more when you come to the chamber office. You get to find out about all the businesses, but you get to see Palmer.
It's a home.
Our dolphin.
It's a home at your chamber.
It
really is.
It really
is. I love
is.
That. Well, it's time for us to take a brief little time out. And when we come back, we're going to have our featured guests come out and talk about what else is happening right down there in the heart of Palm Harbor and the surrounding areas. And Kelly's going to stay with us. Your voice is holding up pretty good.
It is. It's doing good.
Yeah.
Speaking from that diaphragm
See
works.
See that? Low, low. We'll be right back after this. Don't go anywhere, okay?
This is one bee that loves going to the dentist because it's made for you and me.
My name is Dr. Bezerra from New Tampa Pediatric Dental, providing a comfortable atmosphere and early dental care. Gives kids a great start for healthy teeth and gums for life.
My middle son did not like to come to the dentist, but now he loves to come to the beehive.
You don't have to be afraid to go to the dentist.
Believe me, Dr. B and his worker bees are the best. Call New Tampa Pediatric Dental today.
Revolutionary in his field, Dr. Banati created, perfected, and patented the Banati Spine procedures. Using his genius, Banati invented precise tools necessary to minimize surgery, scarring, anesthesia, and recovery. So successful are the Banati Spine procedures, they consistently reflect over 94% patient satisfaction. 45,000 successful procedures have been performed exclusively at our location. Nearly half our patients suffer from failed back and neck surgeries at other facilities. Banati succeeds where others fail.
To My Chamber TV, the heartbeat of our community, and maybe your community if you live in Palm Harbor. I'm your host, Barbara Marville Kelly. Thanks for joining us. We kept Kelly Snow with us. Her voice is holding up in spite of the red tide. Then we have Kiana Chu. Did I say that correctly?
Yes, ma'am.
What a beauty. Now, you are the citrus queen.
Yes.
How exciting. You are very excited. I can tell. I can just, you're exuding with the excitement. So how is this, how did all this come about?
Meeting Miss Kelly at school, Palm Harbor University, and just really trying to get more involved, and yeah.
How fun is that? So now this is part of what we were just kind of setting the show up to let you know what happens in the community, the different events, scholarships. How does that work, Kelly?
Well, we have a couple of businesses in our community that offered scholarships for the Citrus Pageant, and Terry Davis, who's also on our executive board, on our board of directors for the Chamber of Commerce, Huntington Learning Center gives a $500 scholarship for pre-graduation, as in prepping for SATs, ACTs, that kind of thing. And then we also have a sponsored scholarship by one of our main sponsors for college, which she will receive when she graduates from high school.
And wait to hear what she's going to be doing and how she's fulfilling her passion, which is, I'm going to let you share that.
Well, my passion is basketball. Well, I am 6'3", so that kind of helps.
Go figure. I know. Yeah. Very statuesque.
I love basketball. That's what I love to do. And I play for Palm Harbor University currently and a travel basketball team, Tampa Thunder. But that's what I want to do, go to college, play basketball, maybe afterwards. Play professional, that would be my love. But I want to practice, well, in college I'll be studying physical therapy. Just anything could happen, you know, I could get hurt, so that's physical therapy is something that'll keep me kind of in that athletic standpoint of still being around athletes, still being in the basketball world.
So you're keeping your hands on the present, your eyes on the future.
Yes, and I have my plan B, but I'm focused on where I want to go.
My goodness. And you're only a junior.
I'm a junior.
Listen to the drive that this gal has.
Junior and
high school. Boy, we as adults can really learn from you, truly, because this is your passion.
Yes.
And how long have you been playing basketball?
Oh, since always. I think, well, my mom wanted a boy, so I was always pushed in the athlete standpoint. So since I can't remember, I've been a basketball player.
Sounds like you might have been born with a basketball.
Yeah, exactly.
That is so exciting. But I was saying, during the break, that when the young ones like yourself are truly following that passion, it just saves so much later on with trying to figure out what you want to be when you grow up, when you're in your 40s, 50s, or 60s. Yeah. I mean, and that happens, right?
It does.
So this is very refreshing to have you on the show and really
you.
Motivate and inspire people. What would you say to others that have children of your age or where you're going? Did you have supportive parents? So your mom wanted a boy, but let's forget that for a moment.
She still loves me.
She loves you anyway, right?
Yeah.
Well, what do you attribute all this drive from?
Really, my mom is a very hard worker, so I think I get a little bit from her. But really, my mom's always just supported me on whatever I wanted to do, and I just went with it. I have my plan, I plan it out, and I go for it.
Wow, that is so refreshing, especially in today's age. Sometimes there's, families that, they're not all that lucky or supportive and everything.
Oh, no, my mom keeps me on track.
Yes, that's wonderful. And I would guess that is very important, is to have that support. And this is what you have to do and instill those guidelines with you.
Yes, ma'am.
I love it.
She has a great mom. She really does.
That is so fabulous. How long have you guys known one another?
Well, actually, the crazy story is, last year I was giving out applications during lunch at Palm Harbor University High School, and I saw her and I went, "You need to be in our pageant." And she looked at me, and I go, "Come here." And she came over and I gave her an application.
See that?
I mean, just saw her as the queen. I did. She's got to be the queen.
Oh,
and she's represented
goodness.
Our community this entire year at all our ribbon cuttings and the events that we have in the area.
So you show up to all of those, right?
I'm there.
As many as she can.
And that is what your reign is to do,
yes.
Correct?
And then she's in our parade this weekend. So
very
that'll
excited.
Be nice. Yes.
You get the celebrity wave going. Oh, that is nice. No, that's this weekend. And where can we find the parade?
The parade is on our website.
Okay.
And it's also on the CSA website. CSA, I think it's .org. But Palm Harbor Chamber website. And it's going to be down Nebraska.
Oh, okay.
So it starts right past Belcher. There is Westlake Boulevard.
Okay.
Which goes from Alderman to Nebraska. It's going to start there, go all the way down Nebraska to Omaha to 11th to Florida, and end up at the White Chapel.
Oh, the White Chapel.
Which is really neat because at the White Chapel, CSA is going to set up, there's going to be a Santa Claus and Mrs. Claus.
Nice.
And they're going to have snow. Yes. They're going to have snow machines out there. And lots of food and games for the kids.
Oh, how
so
fun.
It just continues after the parade right into that parking lot where the kids get to have fun, the parents get to hang out, and hopefully cold enough to have hot chocolate.
Oh, my goodness. It would be, wouldn't it?
It is.
And so what time does the parade start?
3 o'clock.
3 o'clock in the afternoon.
And you can line up all along the sides of the roads. We don't have barricades, so we ask people to stay on the sides of the roads, throwing beads, candy to everyone, so it'll be fun.
That is going to be fun. And you are in the first parade.
First car.
The marshal.
Oh, I'm the grand marshal. Don't know what that is yet, so somebody's going to have to tell me. But I have a sign on the car, and that's it.
I love it. I love
it'll
it.
It'll be a blast.
Do you know how many you have participating?
I actually don't. I know last year we had over 80 vehicles.
Nice.
Well, because, we have the fire department, the police department, all the, the commissioners, any dignitaries in the area will
yes.
be in the parade.
Yes.
I know Edgar's is going to be there. And it's just going to be recognizing our community. Because Chick-fil-A is going to be there, of course, the cow.
Yes.
Got to put my little plug in there.
Yes, and that's your business.
That
Can
is
the cow
my business.
Sit with me?
Wouldn't that be cute to have the cow next to the queen? Maybe we can put your cars next to each other.
There you go.
We also have a contest for kids to ride on the fire truck. It's a coloring contest where they submit color pages and we judge them. And they
You guys just do it all.
We do a lot. I mean, there's always something going on. It's pretty. Go by our Welcome Center and get the calendar, or go online and get the calendar.
Yes, I know. Well, I know what, Connie Davis, the president, she's been involved with, is it like 30 years
or something? Over 30 years. She is amazing. We couldn't do it without her.
She is amazing and absolutely fun. So much fun. Connie, if you're out there, mwah, we love you and miss you.
She is our queen. She really is the queen of Palm Harbor.
No doubt. And you can tell that she loves doing everything with the chamber.
Well, that's why she's so good at it.
Yeah.
It's a passion. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm sure there's times, because we're exhausted after 3 days of, you know, doing an art show.
Or, of course.
You know, four or five days of such. But it's such a passion for Connie that she just keeps going. Yeah. She calls me the Energizer Bunny. I got actually an Energizer Bunny Award.
I'm not surprised.
At our annual dinner, but I get it from her because she's more so than I am.
She is amazing. She truly is, and I know her and Jewel. They have a relationship from like when they were young, raising their kids.
Yes.
And that's what I love to hear, the stories and how people bond and just that authentic, natural friendship. And then it just blossoms into business and helping the community. And it just seems like when you put your heart and soul into something, as you're finding out, doesn't it make a big difference?
It makes it fun.
Yeah, it makes it fun, and life should be fun, right?
And don't you feel part of a family now?
Oh, always.
Yeah.
Like, I love it. It's
everybody
really
loves her.
Now, when did you become Citrus Queen?
April. Yes, it was April.
It was April.
Last year. Yeah. Very nice. Yeah. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
This is quite an honor. I bet your mom is really, really proud of you, huh?
Yes, my mom is great.
That is really fabulous.
She's a full support. I love it. She's always there at the events. So.
Well, it's very helpful. You need to have that supportive factor in your life if you're going to keep moving forward. You know what I mean?
Something that keeps me sane and grounded.
and focused. And this is my drive. And I'm doing this for me and all those around me to support me and everything. It's really fabulous. Yeah. I congratulate you.
Thank you.
Is there any little tidbits either of you would like to share in the last minute here before we take our break?
Anything you want to talk about? You're going for Citrus Queen again.
Yes, January, right?
January.
Going again, huh?
Going again.
Why
Give
not?
Me a high five. You rock it. Just rock it.
I don't know if we want to tell too many people out there that would be running up against her, but
fair.
But think about it. This year we're having King and Queen.
Now, that's a first.
That's going to be a king and queen court, which we've never had before. I just felt like after all the questions I got last year from guys, where's my application? Why can't, you know, I do? I go, well, it's a scholarship program. Why not?
That's right.
So we're going to have king and queen.
Cool.
Now they actually have to show up.
Yes, they do.
Because they had a big mouth about it.
Yes, they did. So we're going to have to chase them.
There you go. Chase that one down. Absolutely. I love it. Well, Kiana, thank you. You are a delight. Good luck to you. Many blessings and more.
Thank you so much.
And happy holidays to you.
Yes.
We're going to take a brief little time out. And when we come back, we're going to be talking about hunger and what this community is doing for it. We have a very special pastor that's going to be joining us in just moments away. Stay where you are.
Beltran Dental Surgery is dedicated to providing the highest quality dental surgery.
I graduated from USF, went to Harvard Dental School, obtained a medical degree from Texas, and completed 5 years of oral surgery training. At Beltran Dental Surgery, we offer cutting-edge surgical techniques and treatments to the Tampa Bay area. Providing IV sedation allows my patients to have a pain-free and comfortable surgical experience.
From wisdom teeth removal to implants or creating a whole new smile, call now or visit our website to learn more about our procedures.
Ever need a doctor after hours? Well, searching won't help. But what do? You could go to the urgent care or ER, but if only there was a better way. Introducing the MNO Plus Card. No waiting rooms, no copay, no consultation fee. Giving you 24/7 access to a doctor by phone or online. It's easy to get started with affordable plans starting at $15 a month for a family of five. For more information, visit mnoplus.com today.
Everyone's story is different, so why be limited to just one or two options? With Norcom's Norflex Home Loan, you're given the flexibility to tell your story. Pick your terms from 8 to 30 years, all while maintaining a low, fixed mortgage rate. You can pay off your loan more quickly or choose a term based on your budget and timeline. Whatever you do with the Norflex home loan, make it part of your financial plan. Norflex. Short term, long term, your terms. Apply online at norcommortgage.com.
Welcome back into My Chamber TV, the heartbeat of our community. I'm your host, Barbara Marville Kelly. Thank you so much for joining us. Kelly has stayed with us. Our voices are holding up. And we're very pleased to honor the presence of Pastor Mark. Thank you for joining us today. I couldn't believe what you have been doing in the community. You have been involved with Worldwide Word of Faith since 1978.
I've been in the ministry since 1978. Yes. I've known Pastor Kelly and Lonnie for probably 15, 18 years. We coached baseball together. And about 7 years ago, I had an opportunity to come and be a pastor at the church.
That is amazing. And you are making sure that people don't go hungry.
That's our mission, that there none go hungry in North Pinellas.
That is amazing. Let's talk about some of the different things that you're doing, because Kelly and I, we were all talking about this before the show. I was amazed to see the statistics of the children that are going to bed hungry.
Right now, the last Feeding America National Survey, and actually included, of course, Pinellas County, 7,000 children a day do not get adequate food in Pinellas County.
And that affects their learning skills and everything. Their remote,
My son played football for Dunedin, my second oldest son, and we did the team meal when I was pastoring in Dunedin, and the coach said if it wasn't for the team meal, some of these kids wouldn't even get food that day except for lunch at school.
Oh my goodness. So you've actually provided the opportunity for putting the food out there so that this hunger is going down, down, down.
Right. That's our mission, to try to eliminate the hunger. But unfortunately, a year ago, Feeding America did another national study, and 4 years ago, it was one family out of five in Pinellas County had food insecurity. Mm-hmm. Now it's one in four, so it's actually getting worse.
Wow. That is, I tell you, it's just so heartbreaking to think about children going to bed hungry, or anybody going to bed hungry. And so what you're doing, I mean, you gave last year 24,000 pounds of food over 3,800 people.
Right. We distributed over 24,000 pounds of food. And this year, so far, we got another month to go, of course. Our actual food mass distribution is a week from this Wednesday. Mm-hmm. And we'll probably exceed those numbers this year. And because it grows. We get more families. And with the economy the way it is, the family community actually is mom and dad, their children, maybe grandma and grandpa live with them, maybe an aunt or two. So you have a household community of anywhere from 6 to 10 people that need food.
Oh, my goodness. And so you were also telling me about people run out of money after their paychecks or whatever.
What happens is the majority of people that we provide food for have jobs. They're not homeless. I mean, some are, but they're not homeless. They're not out of work. They have jobs, but after they pay their monthly rent, utilities, and their living expenses, that last week of the month, they have no money for food. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. as I was saying before, that person you see at the grocery store that bought a loaf of bread and peanut butter, that might be what they have to live on for that last week.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So we try to provide 4 or 5 days worth of food, depending on what our supply is, mm-hmm. so they get through that last month, that last week.
Mm-hmm. Now, are you doing fundraisers? Is this strictly donations? How can our viewing audience help?
Okay, if there are businesses, they can donate. They can do a food drive. We've had several businesses this year do food drives for us. They can donate funds to us. We will give them a letter for tax purposes for them, because we go through Feeding America. We're an agency of Feeding America. That's why when people come in to get food, we have to fill out certain paperwork. We don't get anything personal. It's just your address, how many are in your family, and that we record that, because they come in once a year. We have an annual inspection from Feeding America, make sure we're keeping up to standards, make sure we're not selling the food and things like that. Mm-hmm. And if companies, I know I spoke at the Palm Harbor Chamber of Commerce, their annual banquet, and the business people there were stunned when they found out those figures, that they were ranked 28th out of the top 100 metropolitan areas in America for food shortage. And several people there had owned businesses, said they would do food drives for us this coming year.
Very
that's
good.
The biggest way. Our congregational members donate both funds and food.
Wonderful.
And with the funds, we can go to Feeding America, and we can purchase food at 18 cents a pound.
Mm-hmm.
So that
mm-hmm.
that's just a blessing, because otherwise, no church would really be able to go out to a grocery store and buy 24,000 pounds of food for
the
year.
Oh, my goodness. Absolutely not. And this is really one of the things that we were talking about, the events and different drives that you prepare in the community, because you're not a city, right?
Right.
And it's up to you to really do all this.
I have to. There's no choice. And we do, like you said, there's companies in the chamber. Geographic Solutions has adopted our food pantry for this Christmas.
Nice.
And they're taking up in both their locations, you know, collecting food, non-perishable food.
Right. What we try to do, especially November and December, we try to provide enough food and, if possible, a turkey or a ham so they can have a Thanksgiving dinner and a Christmas dinner with their family.
Mm-hmm.
Not just, you know, get some non-perishables and have a dinner, but try to make it a little special for them.
Exactly. Now, there was something else that you had mentioned, too, because food stamps has been an offer to some families, but not everyone, because there's a certain criteria that they have to fulfill, right?
Right. You can actually make very little money, but make too much to qualify for a total amount of food stamps. You may get $50 a month to buy food, and which families can't live off of that, so they're struggling going to different food banks trying to get food to feed their kids.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just so disheartening when you see the affluence we have around here, to think that the hunger is right among us, where kids are going to bed with no food, and they've proven that the children that don't have adequate food have a learning disability.
Absolutely.
They can't learn in school. Their Absolutely. Grades aren't as good as the other children.
Exactly.
And that's our goal, just to reach out and help people.
Absolutely.
And that's our whole thing. When we started this 7 years ago, the reason was we had several people coming from our community asking, do you have a food bank? Can we get food? Do you have food vouchers or cards for Publix? And I know Pastor Lonnie, Pastor Kelly's husband, and Pastor Kelly and I sat there and said, why don't we look into having a food bank? So I investigated it, saw what criteria we had to have to go through Feeding America. They came, inspected us, we met their criteria, and we've been doing it for approximately 7 years now.
That is amazing, and that is definitely satisfying to be able to do that.
And like I said, it's grown. When we first did our first distribution 7 years ago, we had 12 families, maybe 40, 42 people. Our highest, of course, in the month of December, is we were about 100 families and over 400 people.
Wow.
So you can see how it's, and it continually grows every year.
Yes, yes. Wow, that's amazing. I know you're excited about this, too, and I was thrilled to have, because we try to have a charity on our shows at least one every week, and this is a great way to do that. We have to be able to eat and nourish ourselves, and the kids are growing. They need that nourishment in order to think.
And I think one of the blessings for us was Palm Harbor, that we were awarded the 503 Nonprofit Company of the Year.
No kidding.
Based on the help we gave the community and everything. I think that's our goal. We don't want the awards. We just want to help people.
I know.
And get the word out.
Yes.
See, that's just another
yes.
way to get the word out what we're doing
yes.
and what the food pantry is providing
right.
for our community.
I've had the opportunity to speak on behalf of Feeding America at various fundraisers at Seven Springs Country Club.
Yes.
And they were stunned again when I gave these businessmen, it was a golf outing, and when I gave, I spoke at the dinner, and I told them those exact figures, the 28th in America for lack of food, and 7,000 kids a day don't get food. They were stunned. They couldn't believe it.
Right.
They couldn't
right.
believe it.
So. I was. I. You know, when you're not living that way, you're removed from it. But when you see those statistics and you're thinking, oh, my goodness, that's just unacceptable.
It is.
It really is. And so
and if people want to be part of the solution, they can, you know, donate, do a food drive. They can go to our website, w3fc.org, and there's a links to the food pantry, what they can do, and they can be a solution. They can really, this year, we'd love to eliminate it. We'd love to have 10 families need food from us instead of 100 a month.
Well, you'll get there because you have the drive. Let me ask you something. Mm-hmm. If somebody wanted to have a food drive, how does that work?
What they do, they can just contact us. We will bring to them containers with the literature and nice design containers. We'll drop it off at their site. They can collect non-perishables, of course, for us, and we'll be glad to come pick it up.
Exactly. We'll come
and get it. They don't have to deliver it or anything else. We'll come get it for them. We'll give, if they like a letter for their income tax filing, we'll do that too.
Okay, perfect. That is so great. I'm really honored to have you out here and doing this and being able to raise the awareness in the community. That's the one thing that I love doing is giving back, is having a voice and raising the awareness to all of you out there. I this is just amazing. I'm so happy that you came on the show to share this.
I thank you. And we also, besides that, the monthly third Wednesday of the month, we serve people on a walk-in basis every day.
Yes. Okay.
We don't turn anybody away. We never don't give anybody food. We look at what we have on our distribution day and go, okay, maybe we're a little low this month. Let's give every family at least one bag of food so everybody gets something.
Okay. And what's in a bag of food?
We try to do the basic categories, peanut butter, cereal, canned meats, especially tuna fish, pasta, soup, canned vegetables, and canned fruit. We try to give them so they have a balanced diet, especially for the children.
So where, if somebody wanted to come and see if they would qualify or pick food up, what is their process?
They can come in to the church. They can come in on the third Wednesday of the month. We have probably 8 to 10 new families every month coming in. And the way we have it set up, we have a group of people at the table where we have a master list of people that have qualified through by the filling of paperwork out for Feeding America. We check them off, let them know they're here. We give them a number, and then new people come in. They fill out the forms, and they get food that day.
That day.
There's
no waiting period or anything like that.
If someone walks in, and they're homeless off the street, we just give them food. We don't ask any questions. We ask no questions, no personal questions. If you need food, we give it to you.
And God bless you.
The address is, in case anybody wants to know, is 1588 Klosterman Road. In Palm Harbor.
Mm-hmm. Perfect, so, perfect.
Come by anytime. Somebody's there.
we're there. They can call 727-942-9700. That's our church office. They can leave a message or talk to the person who answers the phone. Just tell them if they need food, and we'll tell them the process.
Right, or go on the website.
It sounds pretty easy.
It is.
It sounds really
easy.
And, you know, another opportunity that people can have is they can be part of the distribution if they want to come in and help, especially kids that need, like, you know, Bright Future Hours and stuff.
Right.
We open up the doors for people to come and be part of the giving. Does something when you give.
Oh, boy, isn't that the truth?
It's a combined effort of our people in our church.
Yes.
Because it takes, on distribution day, it takes 12 to 14 people to distribute that amount of food in the process. Because we have to weigh it, log it in, so Feeding America gets the weights that we give out each distribution, and it's just it's a process. We've got it down to a science now. After
you do, my goodness, it's all laid out there. So yeah. I'm sure that it's going to keep going strong, and hopefully we can reduce the hunger, at least in our community. I like what you said about being part of the solution.
Right.
When you hear this, don't look the other way. You know, raise the awareness to others, and nobody needs to go to bed hungry.
No.
And I just got to say, God bless both of you. I'm so glad that you both came together and you're working towards this.
Right.
And anything we can do to help out, and even if it's like this, bringing you on the show to raise this awareness, our show will be archived. And you'll be able to tell others to see this show and hear the process when you go to www.webeamtv.com, click on to My Chamber TV, and it will be there till eternity. So we're going to help you out over here.
Well, I appreciate that.
Continue.
Just getting the word out. That's what we need.
Just get the word out.
And get the word out that we're there.
We're there
to serve the people.
Yes, absolutely. Will you come back?
Absolutely.
Awesome. I love getting my own way. Well, you have a beautiful, blessed holiday season.
You too.
And thank you again. And you're sticking around with me. And you, I hope, will stick around with me as well. I get moved with these kind of topics here. We'll be back in just a few, okay?
This is one bee that loves going to the dentist because it's made for you and me.
Providing a comfortable atmosphere in early dental care gives kids a great start for healthy teeth and gums for life.
Coming here, you're not just like an ordinary patient. You're actually like treated like a family member, and like you're treated like he actually gets to know you and makes you smile.
Welcome to New Tampa Pediatric Dental, and we are the
Bees!
Call New Tampa Pediatric Dental today.
Revolutionary in his field, Dr. Benatti created, perfected, and patented the Benatti spine procedures. Using his genius, Benatti invented precise tools necessary to minimize surgery, scarring, anesthesia, and recovery. So successful are the Benatti spine procedures, they consistently reflect over 94% patient satisfaction. 45,000 successful procedures have been performed exclusively at our location. Nearly half our patients suffer from failed back and neck surgeries at other facilities. Benatti succeeds where others fail.
Welcome to My Chamber TV, the heartbeat of our community. We're just having a good time sharing what's going on in the community. I have to say, because I know Jewel's watching. I did a Jewel today. I did a Jewel
with a slit
up the side. See?
She did a Jewel slit.
See, that's just for you, Jewel, because she weren't here today. But in this last segment here, we're going to be talking to Kelly Snow, who has been very involved with the Chamber. She's going to be our spokesperson. We're honored to have you. And I know Jewel is out there in the community making her difference as usual, and we just love you for that. But you've had some different little things that you've been up to and discovering, and you spoke last night, and you had something you were starting to share during the break, but I said, I'll save that. We'll share that in this segment. So tell me.
Well, I am also one of my hats. You've discovered some of my hats today, but I'm the marketing director for the Palm Harbor Chamber, Palm Harbor Chick-fil-A.
And one of the things that I get to do, because I have a passion for people.
That's, really?
Really? Is no question there.
We would have never known that.
It's what led me to everything that I do. But what I got to do, I was asked to speak Walmart Marketplace. I'm sure you guys are getting more familiar with that. That's the smaller Walmart.
Yes.
Roma, who owns or manages the one in Oldsmar, asked me to come and speak to all the area managers about Chick-fil-A culture. Because we do. We have a certain way of running Chick-fil-A, and people never can understand how do you have the nicest people, you know, work for you. And I said, okay, well, I'll come share because I do know a great deal about it. I live it. And they held it at HEP. It's Homelessness Empowered Program. It's down in Clearwater. Never heard of this program before. So I spoke to all these managers, and then they took us on a tour. Absolutely amazing what this facility does for our area and our community.
Tell us.
It doesn't matter where you live, if you're a veteran, if you're homeless, if you've been an abused wife, mother, you know, a husband who lost their family, anybody that's really needs housing, food, clothing. They even provide transportation. They get bicycles donated, and they had this whole community. It's homes that a pastor, he owned a home, and he refurbished it to keep people who were in urgent need of a place to live, even if it was just for a night. Mm-hmm. And he just started purchasing homes in the area, converted this whole area in downtown Clearwater. And it's by mainly their funds, I found out, come some from government, grants only. That's what's given to them. And they do have someone there that writes the grants. And they also have Walmart that donates food, clothing, bicycles. But the rest of it's private, secular. You know, people like us give to them. And I'm really going to reach out. They don't know us yet, but Chick-fil-A corporate, to get connected and really do something and make a difference in
Absolutely.
These people's lives.
Absolutely. I had no idea. See, since I've been doing this show and finding out this is amazing stuff.
It is. And there, you know, so many of us are blind, I guess, or don't see the needs that are out there. Mm-hmm. And just one step to the left, and all of a sudden you're in this whole world. And you're like, wow, these people are really making a difference. Mm-hmm. You know, just open your eyes and start looking. But this is a perfect place to find out where the needs are
exactly.
in our area.
Exactly. That's why I love doing these shows, is raising the awareness. Because, an hour show seems like, you know, an hour is an hour. But we could probably have these shows throughout the entire week. And you just never know how we may be growing with more chambers and possibly more chamber shows, because, Tampa Bay Multimedia gives back in the community too. Just absolutely amazing. We're out filming and raising the awareness, replaying little film clips from different events that's going on in the community. I'm so proud to be working here at Tampa Bay Multimedia. And my Chamber TV has actually been going now for almost 2 years. Did you know that?
Wow, no.
I know. It seems like just yesterday when I got the phone call.
That is amazing. Just this, finding out about my Chamber TV, I didn't know about it. And when I did, I was like so curious. Even before I came on the show, I did a lot of research to find out more about it. People need to know.
Yes.
I mean, this is how much more convenient can you get than your phone?
Exactly.
To find out what's out there.
Exactly.
In your area.
It's true, because every week we honor a different chamber, and they're growing leaps and bounds. And so chances are we may end up doing, you know, an additional show to really give the exposure to what's happening in this absolutely phenomenal community. It really is phenomenal. The give back, the fundraisers, the different events, and marketing your business too.
Absolutely.
We've been talking a lot about the charities, but what have you found in this last segment here, Kelly, as far as being a member of a chamber? How does it help businesses? What if somebody is just watching? Maybe they've been a member of a chamber in the past, maybe not necessarily Palm Harbor, and they left. And they say, I'm sure you've heard this. Well, the chamber didn't do anything for me.
You know what? I am the past chairman of the board, served last year as the chairman, and that's what I found out about because I was so curious. So I asked him straight up, why aren't you in the chamber anymore? Well, they didn't do anything for me. Guess what my response was?
I bet I know.
What did you do for them?
Yeah, exactly.
What have you done for me lately?
That's right.
But it's the truth.
Yes.
I'm going to talk to you out there. I don't care how pampered chef to a multi-million dollar corporation. Mm-hmm. Get in the chamber because that's your exposure. I, just as my little Chick-fil-A in Palm Harbor, I've had so many opportunities come to me. Because I'm at coffee hour. That's how I met Roma, was part of being at the chamber.
Yes.
And he found out that I was Chick-fil-A, and he's like, I need you to come and speak about your culture. Mm-hmm. You know, and then I had an opportunity to give out our coupons that everybody loves. If you see me in the community, I'll be giving you free Chick-fil-A. And, you know, that was an opportunity. And then in turn, the library asked me to be there with the cow. I get to be in parades. I mean, all this came from being in the Chamber of Commerce.
Yes. Yes.
I'm going to tell you, it's not just me. Yeah, I've been involved in the community because I had five kids go through the schools. You know, I have
right.
two daughters
you
in high school now.
You can't help but be involved.
You can't help. But this is a whole new door opening, new windows opening once you get in the chamber. You think, well, oh, I know people. Or, you know, Palm Harbor's so small that I know enough people. No, I was shocked. I thought I knew everyone.
Yeah.
Knew.
Yeah.
I found out there was a whole new area of people.
Yes.
That I've been introduced to.
Yes, absolutely. When you have a small business, and it's so critical, and especially today, and I say this a lot, I don't mean to sound redundant, but even if there's one person that can hear me out with this one comment that Jewel said when in the first couple of shows, and ever since then, I hung on to it. Business is not as usual anymore.
No.
It's step out of the box. What makes you different from the next person
yes.
in the same kind of
yes.
business that you have? We must be able to step out of the box today, don't we, Kelly?
And the creative ideas that just come now, you know, with all the exposure and the social media, and the chamber is the perfect place to get that exposure that you need mm-hmm. and get those connections. I mean, I have a social media person now. Because I was in the chamber, I was introduced to someone at St. Pete College who found me someone to do my social media for me. I mean, you're not going to find that.
No.
Just
no.
in your everyday clock in, clock out
right.
work day.
Right. It's true. It's true. And really, I've learned so much just in business alone. And sometimes we might get a little stuck in our small business,
yes.
and we keep doing the same thing over and over, and we wonder why things aren't growing. Maybe we're falling down a few rungs on the ladder as far as success and all that. Get out and get involved.
That's right.
And really tap into the heartbeat of your community, because it's there.
It is.
That pulse of the heartbeat in your community is definitely there. All you have to do is go knock on the door. You'll get the answers that you're looking for. I've seen it time and time again with all the chamber members, all the guests that we have on My Chamber TV. It is absolutely critical to get involved and go to some of these different, the coffees, there's breakfast, there's lunches, there's mixers and dinners and so many different events. And even if you don't go to all of them, I mean, it's utterly impossible to get to all of them, but even if you can just start, you know, feeling your way,
absolutely.
Going to a few and meeting people and meeting those people that you want to know, like, and trust. And I'll tell you, since I've started going to meetings and doing these shows, I have a whole plethora
yeah.
of people I can call. Air conditioners, repairs.
Isn't that amazing?
You name it.
And
exactly.
People ask me, I've become the information person. It's hysterical because they know that I know so many more people now.
Yes.
Can you find me this? Can you find me that?
Yes, yes.
And you know, I want to go back to something you said. What's the definition of insanity?
Doing the same thing over and over and not seeing any change
yeah.
in your results.
And you expect your results to be different and you're doing the same
right.
thing. Time to
right.
shake it up.
It is time to shake it up. And I'll tell you, that's one thing I owe it to Jewel McKeon.
Yes, Jewel.
P3 Agency. You're here in spirit with us today and always. But she just would give these little tidbits and it really gets you to thinking and going, That's so true.
It's true. And it could be a phone call. You could, like, and Jewel is a good person. If you're feeling dry,
Like, I need a new idea.
Yeah.
And I've done that to her.
I've
called her ribbon cutting and said, Jewel, help me here.
I know.
And she's there and does it for me. So.
I know. Jewel, we love you and miss you. We only have a few seconds to close our show today, but I want to thank you and your guests for coming on. You're going to be the liaison. And I know Jewel will be coming back.
Yes.
Between you and
us.
I know she's missing us, too.
She is.
So she'll be back for another guest on the show, and you already have your next 2 months planned.
I do.
I am so proud of you, girlfriend. Good for you.
I am so ready.
Yes, you are ready. Well, that's going to be exciting.
It is.
So the parade is this weekend.
Don't miss it.
3 o'clock Saturday, and that's going to be loads of fun. And you are the grand marshal in the front parade.
That's right.
Oh my
Amazing.
Goodness. That's going to be fun. I can't wait.
Yeah, I had to go get a new outfit, you know.
Well, but of course.
Of course.
And you'll have your bling on, I know.
You know it.
Thank you. You are such a jewel. You really are.
Well,
we'll see you next time, and you will be coming on for the third week in the month for Palm Harbor Chamber of Commerce.
Yes.
I want to thank you for being kind enough to tune into our show today. In the meantime, have a beautiful and blessed week. We'll see you next week, same time, same place.